Hello, today we're looking at Endless OS 3.4.8. So, this is a very interesting operating system because it's based on Debian, it uses a lot of flatpaks, but there's something unique to this system which separates it from all the rest, all other operating systems, and we will get to it. So, first of all, when we start with Endless, we get this initial setup phase, which is very similar to GNOME, because this is based on GNOME 3.26. It's old, but that is not the goal of Endless to be the latest version. And I will so the goal of Endless is basically, if you want people to have knowledge of topics, but you either don't want them to have internet connection, or they don't have internet where they are living. Which sounds strange for most of us, because where in the world is there not internet? But I know for a fact, like when I was in, me and my family lived for 2 months, 20 minutes walk from Lake Baikal, and there the best internet we could find, and we were managers in a guest house, was 3G internet. 3G. And we were like, in that area, we were one of the few people who got internet. And we were one of the most visited stores, attraction places on Lake Baikal. There's other places which just doesn't have that option, even 3G. How crazy is that? And people still need knowledge, and this ISO, which I downloaded, the 17 gigabyte one, 70 gig is filled with knowledge. So you can put this in a remote place in Africa or in Siberia or wherever you want, or in the Amazon, and people can come there in a public place and get knowledge and get up to date with what's going on in the world. And it's such a vital thing. So if it's used correctly, placed in the right place, this is amazing. And they got some really cool apps and functions here, which we will look at now. Other things which I like, it is also brilliant for places where, in big cities, where you don't want internet. Like in jails or places like that, where you don't want people to have internet, but you want them to learn about the world and see what's up to date with the world and have an encyclopedia and some games which will make the brain work and things like that, and this is perfect for that also. So there's many places for it, but there is, so it's endless in that sense, but it's also limited in other senses. So let's quickly click around. So as you can see, every day you will have like news, but it's all built into your system and it's like tells you about the history of the world, and so it is just like good news to read, but it is not like news which we know in the world, but it's news about the world, which will about the history, about Wikipedia. They use a lot of Wikipedia, and it's just a very good way for people to, for all of us to learn of education. You can also use this at your home if you have like a extra computer and you got children and you want them to learn skills about the world, learn encyclopedia, maths, games, which is fun, things like that, things you want people to study. Brilliant. Just have it in your house. So there's so many functions for this system. You can search Google straight from your desktop. It's very much like an Android feeling computer. Google Chrome, you got it. So if you just want a daily browser, this is also perfect for it. Also the problem which I have with Endless. I told you all the good things and I mean it all out of my heart, but there is a downside also to Endless, and that is a big downside in my eyes. You can't use, as you can see, you even got AdBlock and Google works just fine. You've got your documents, GNOME 3.26. You can't install packages from your terminal. So you can't install any Linux app. You can only install the apps which is inside the software center and any Flatpak. You can't go sudo apt install snapd. You can't install anything. You can't download their packages. And install it. You can download them, of course, but they put a limit on to what you can do with your system. If you are in the limit, it's endless, but if you try to get out of the limit, it's very limited. If it makes sense. So if this is put in the wrong situation, it's not a good OS. If it's put in the right situation, it's amazing. It's the latest of LibreOffice 6.1.2. The encyclopedia is basically Wikipedia, which is fantastic. So you can search for anything. Let's search for Rugby World Cup 1995 and see. So it basically shows us all they got on Wikipedia. For World Cups, FIFA, let's say, Rugby World Cup 1995. It is South African, I love my rugby. And you can get some nice information in a nice downloaded offline Wikipedia. You can install VLC, also from the Software Center. And this is just an Electron. It will just open up Facebook inside your browser, YouTube inside your browser, WhatsApp for your phones, connect. And you will get the media. Things are starting to get interesting. This photo editor is one of the best photo editors that are for Linux and simple for the whole world. So basically, we are able to use this everywhere because it's such an easy to use photo editor. I'm absolutely in love with it. I wish I had a photo on. And then you got Tux Paint. And the other one which stands out for me is World Literature. So this is basically ebooks in a nice package which is already downloaded and people can read it and enjoy it. Children's stories. The Tale of Peter Rabbit. Some of them don't work, but most of them work at the box, and you can read here about Peter Rabbit. So cool that it's all downloaded and easy to use. Curiosity is a very, very nice application. Because if you want to learn about maths, that's good instruction. If you want to learn languages, Duolingo is fantastic. I made some Russian lessons with the usage of it. Ralph, if somebody is sick in your family, if you don't feel good and you don't know what to do, there's no doctor close by because you're in a very odd place in the world. What? So, yeah, you can learn about all the things. If you're at home, somebody is sick and you quickly need to get an answer, you can come and check here. It's so cool and useful to have this. Games is all educational games. So let's say, for instance, you want to learn maths. So then you open Tuck Maps. Of course, you can use it anywhere. Not just on Endless, but it's cool. It's all here built in for remote places which they don't have games if they need to learn maths. So let's say play alone. Number typing. So now you type your number and then you shoot the explosives. So, 2. Bam! How cool is that, eh? So then you basically just do mathematics and when you're correct, you pass. So that's a really cool game for like children to learn mathematics and things like that. So social is just links to the world. And it's also a game, Montes. I think it's similar to Minecraft. It's got me the same feeling, as you can see. And then cooking is a recipe book, music, it is just the default for Linux, but they got a lot of music downloaded, Rhythmbox, but it's a lot of default stuff, so you can listen to a lot by not having internet or anything. More apps. This is the GNOME Software Center. And Ubuntu said they want to make a revamp of the Software Center. Take the Software Center and put it in Ubuntu. It is amazing. As you can see, it's very similar to your previous release of the Deepin Software Center, and it's very useful, it's easy to understand, it's good categories, and they've done something amazing here. And they got a lot of their own apps, and I love the structure. I can understand exactly what's going on, and it works just fine. Even if you can install Steam, so that's cool, and you have so many packages installed and updates is here. And they also got automatic updates, which is a setting in your system settings, GNOME system settings in this app. You can turn it off or on. It's up to you. So that's actually a really, really nice distro. This button here will show any open windows with your apps which you could open. This is your user account. You can change this if you want to any different picture you want. Like this, and you can browse for more pieces, and as you can see, it's normal GNOME 3.26 settings, details, 3.4.8, and yes, the update function which I told you about, automatic updates, which you can configure here. And your off button is here, your lock button is there. There's tons of beautiful wallpapers for you to look at. And you got your calendar here in the corner, your GNOME stuff. So it's all GNOME, but it's such a nice layout. Yes, your open windows will appear here, and also it's quite cool. And then you can also remove any app from your desktop if you want to do it. And this button here simply shows your desktop. So let's say cooking. It just shows your desktop. So that's actually quite cool how it works. So yeah, it's a very complete system. It's unique. It got a unique market, and it's fantastic that it's there. Thank you for watching. See you later. Goodbye.